Dear citizens of Turkey, I would like to address you on the country report which we issued today. Turkey is a key strategic partner for the European Union and a candidate country, but it has unfortunately not made progress with the necessary reforms. Most worryingly, in the crucial area of fundamental rights, Turkey has taken significant steps backwards. We understand, of course, that the coup attempt of nearly 2 years ago, which the European Union condemned in the strongest terms, fundamentally changed the security situation in Turkey. But many of the measures taken over the last couple of years and being still in place are disproportionate. As a candidate country and as a member of the Council of Europe, Turkey has committed to the same high democratic standards as every member state of the Union and to meet the challenges of the European integration process. Today's analysis shows that the deficits related to the core values of the European Union, fundamental freedoms, human rights, the rule of law, and the independence of the judiciary, have not gone away since our last report. In fact, they have become worse. Journalists, human rights activists, members of civil society are still being imprisoned. Since the introduction of the state of emergency, more than 150,000 people have been taken into custody, and many are still detained. The separation of powers and the independence of the judiciary are key to a functioning democracy. In a democracy, everyone is innocent until proven guilty. Those accused of wrongdoing have the right to a fair trial. We see a serious erosion of these rights in Turkey and urge the government to set about normalizing the situation. I hope to see Turkey reverse these worrying trends and set in motion a process of deep and sustainable reforms and implement in full the recommendations that we and other organizations like the Council of Europe have already made. All this is in the interest of Turkey's citizens. Of course, we will continue to cooperate in areas of mutual interest where progress is possible, including the economy, transport, and energy. We will continue working together to encourage people-to-people contacts, particularly in the field of education and research. And we will continue to work as partners in trying to combat terrorism and resolve the migration crisis. I appreciate Turkey's and the Turkish people's extraordinary efforts in welcoming over 3 million refugees. Since we committed to addressing this crisis together, the number of deaths at sea rapidly declined, and there was a fall in the overall number of illegal immigrants. The European Union continues to stand by Turkey, and it's helping to fund projects on the ground, providing primary health care, education, and socio-economic support for the most vulnerable. 72 projects worth 3 billion euro founded by the European Union are currently running in Turkey, delivering concrete support to the refugees. Turkey has repeatedly stated that it is committed to European Union membership. As for all enlargement countries, the only way to measure this very important commitment is implementation on the ground. Today's report confirms that this process cannot move forward unless Turkey reverses the worrying trend on democracy and fundamental rights substantially.